Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello student, welcome back. In the last class or in the last video, I have covered GBN protocol. That is nothing but go back and the main reason we use that protocol is to fill the pipeline with the packet, so that which will avoid the channel utilization problems which we were noted with the stop and wait protocols. But this GBN also suffers from some performance problem. Particular, when the window size and the bandwidth delay product is both are large. I repeat, when the window size and bandwidth products both are large, many packets can be in the pipeline without acknowledged. So a single packet error can thus cause GBN to retransmit a large number of packets, which unnecessarily once again increase the bandwidth and which leads to so many problems. So what is the solution for this one? The solution for this one is selective repeat. As the name suggests, selective repeat protocol avoids the unnecessary transmission by having sender retransmit only those packets that suspects were received in error. That suspects were received in error. So in selective repeat, receiver individually acknowledge all correctly received packet. That means out of order packet also, if it is received properly, it will store it, buffer it. And later it will pass that to upper layer, but it will buffer it and it will acknowledge it. Sender only responds packet for which acknowledgement not received. Second point. So sender window contains the size of the sender window is nothing but sequence number size, and there is a limitation for the sequence number. So now we will see here, you can see here, this is same like our GBN. Only the difference is sender and receiver, both here receiver maintain receiver window. You can see a receiver window. So here this is a send base and this is the next sequence number. This is already acknowledged packet. This is sent not acknowledged, and this is the next sequence number to be sent. So the different colors are have been used here. You can see yellow means the sent one not acknowledged, and in between you can see some acknowledged packets are there. So in the receiver window also, you can see red color packet. This is out of order packet, but expected not at received acknowledgement. Expected or not at received packet is represented by like this. So when it receives this packet, window size will receiver window this one will move. Receiver window will move. Here on the sender side, when it receives acknowledgement for this packet, sender window will slide. So this is the selective repeat. So in the selective repeat, one thing you have to remember: each packet, the sender, when it sends each packet, logically it starts the timer. In the case of go back and n, the first base packet it will start the timer. But it is here not like that. In this case, logically for all the packets, because if one packet, particular packet timeouts, then it will send only those packet, that packet. But in the go back and n, the base packet timeout, it will send the entire unacknowledged packets in that window. So that is the difference between selective repeat and go back. So the algorithm is something like this: data from the above. If the sequence numbers are available in the window, send the packet. If the timeout, resend the packet and start the timer. As soon as they receive the pack acknowledgement, then mark the packet as received. And on the receiver side, this is the algorithm. Now you can see here, selective repeat. So sender window size is n is equal to 4. Window size is n is equal to 4. That is, it is sending 0, 1, 2, 3. Packet 0, 1, 2, 3. So receive, it will send packet 0, packet 1, packet 2, packet 3. As the receiver receives the packet, it will acknowledge. The receiver here received the packet. It has received the packet. So send acknowledgement 0, received packet 1, send acknowledgement 0. So here the packet is lost. Send packet is lost. It will send the packet 3. But receiver has received the packet 3. It will buffer it. It has not received the packet 2. So it will send the acknowledgement 3. It will send the acknowledgement 3. So, as soon as here, sender, as soon as it receives acknowledgement 0 and acknowledgement 1, window will slide. You can see window will slide and it will send packet 5 and packet 4 and packet 5. Meanwhile, packet 2, time is timeout. For packet 2, time is timeout. And here, receiver, it has not received packet 2, so it cannot assemble the entire things. So what it will do, it will buffer it. It will not send the data to the higher layer. It will buffer it. So here, as soon as the timer for the packet 2 timeouts, it will resend the packet and receiver will resend the acknowledgement and it will deliver all these packet to the upper layer. So here in this diagram, it has shown only something like packet 2 timer, but logical timer will be started for the each packet as it sends. So that you have to remember, and how the window will slide is shown here. Now select repeat, we have one question. So there is a question that is, first one is window size that is 1 less than the size of the sequence number space will not work in selective repeat. So in GBN we use that. Here it will not work. So how small must be the window size? Answer is, window size must be less than or equal to half the size of sequence number space for SR protocols. Window size must be less than or equal to half the size of the sequence number space for SR protocols. Window size that is less than the size of the sequence number space will not work. So this one, window size must be less than or equal to half the size of the sequence number space for SR protocol, that we'll see now. So you take here, sequence number 0, 1, 2, 3, window size is 3. Sequence number is 0, 1, 2, 3, window size is 3. That means it is sending 0, 1, 2. Packet 0 is sent, 1 is sent, 2 is sent. Packet 3 is lost. It will send packet 2 is, 3 is lost. So here you can see window will, as it receives the acknowledgement, window will actually slide. So now it is sending 0. So here, our receiver will accept the packet with the sequence number 0 correctly. There is no problem. But you see this one, the second one. Packet 0 is sent, packet 1 is sent, packet 2 is sent. Acknowledgement is lost. So what it will do? Acknowledgement is lost. All it will do, it will time out and it will retransmit 0, 1, 2, 3. So that time, it will our receiver will accept 0 and 1 also. It will accept the packet number 0 and 1. But you see, our sender has transmitted original 012 original 012 from the first this one slot. But receiver will think here, because it has received the first slot 012 properly, and acknowledgement is lost, and that is not the problem of receiver. Receiver will not come to know whether the acknowledgement is reached or not. So when sender repeats 012, it will take it as a new set of sequence 012. This is the problem. So in order to avoid this one, as I said, window size must be less than or equal to half of the size of the sequence number space for SR protocols. So that is the answer. So here the question can be, what is the relationship between sequence and window size? Sequence size and window size, to avoid the problem. So my dear students, now you have completed reliable protocols, which comes under 3.4. The next one is 3.5, connection oriented transport, the TCP. In that, what is the TCP segment structure? Then what is reliable transfer, data transfer? What do you mean by flow control, connection management and condition protocols? All these things we have to see in the next class.